So today I'm going to discuss an example on the analysis or investigation of beam bearing plate. The next sample problem is actually taken from an actual CE board exam, wherein an A36 W24 by 62 beam is supported by an A53 bearing plate 300 by 200 by 25 millimeter on concrete wall thickness of 300 millimeters. So meaning the steel, the FY of the steel beam is different from the FY of the beam bearing plate. At the same time, the dimension of the bearing plate were given, but it was not specified which of those dimensions is the length, the width, and most likely the thickness is considered as the 25 millimeters already. Then the thickness of the wall, concrete wall, is also given as 300 millimeters. Now the properties of the beam were also given, the depth, the BF, the thickness of the web, etc. Okay, then the FY values of the A53 steel is also given to be 241, and the concrete FC prime is also given 24 megapascal. So we're asked to determine for the ultimate end beam reaction considering the following conditions. And these three conditions were: one is due to bearing strength of concrete wall, number two is due to the bending strength of the bearing plate, and number three is due to web yielding of the beam web. Okay, so these are the given based from the problem. So the properties of the wide flange beam, the FY, the bearing plate, the FY, and its dimension, and the concrete wall whose FC prime and the thickness were given also. Okay, so for the solution, number one, or letter part or part A, would be what would be the ultimate reaction daw, R sub U, against bearing. Now, it was given in the problem or in the question that what should be the design bearing strength on concrete wall with given phi. Okay, so nakasulat dun eh. This one, it was given in the problem that the design strength phi Rn is equal to 0.65 FC prime A1. Diba kapag ka ganito yung Rn natin, that means full area. Kasi wala siyang square root of A2 over A1. Ibig sabihin, sinasabi sa problem that the bearing plate is resting on full area. Okay, so kung full area siya, ibig sabihin dapat yung base plate natin, yung bearing plate natin, kung ano yung LB niya, kung ano yung haba niya, kung ano yung LB niya, dapat pares yan dun sa thickness ng wall. Diba? Kung ito yung thickness ng wall. Para siya maging full area. Ako nyo? So, ang thickness ng wall was given to be 300. So, para siya maging full area, ibig sabihin yung 300 na dimension dito should be the length. Ito yung L sub B. Ayun. Okay, kasi kapag ka, ang gagamitin nating L sub B is yung 200, hindi siya magfo-full area. Okay? So, ganun yung pag-a-analyze ng problem. So, therefore, yung LB natin is 300, tapos yung B natin is 200. Tapos, of course, yung thickness natin is yung 25. So, ganyan yung magiging dimension natin ng bearing plate. Okay? So, for Rn, so design strength natin is phi Rn greater than or equal to Ru, phi is 0.65 for bearing, diba? Okay, so substitute lang natin, the Ru would be 0.65 times Rn, Rn is 0.85 times FC prime, tapos ito yung LB times B. So we got this answer, Ru of 795.6 kilonewtons. So that would be the ultimate reaction. Actually, for this part of the solution, wala pang effect yung LB tsaka N. Kahit ma-interchange natin silang dalawa, it would give us the same final answer to 795. So wala pa siyang effect dito. Okay, next. How about considering bending? Okay, considering bending, so thickness formula yung gagamitin natin for this case. Okay? So we will be using the thickness formula. Ang ginamit ko dito yung N square sa loob ng radical sign, nilabas ko lang kaya siya naging N na lang. So substitute ko lang yung thickness, 25. Tapos yung N ko would be B minus 2K over 2. So yan yung n ko. Then square root of 2.2 RU BLB times FY. Again, FY is the FY of the, sino ba yung nagbe-bend? So yung base plate. So 241. So with LB of 300 and B of 200, so we substitute those values in the equation. The RU would be 963.537 kilonewtons. So substitute mo lang lahat dun sa equation. So ang lalabas na RU would be 963. Okay? Dito may problema na tayo pagka napag-interchange natin yung LB tsaka B. No? So dapat dito alam natin na yung LB is 300 tapos yung B natin is 200. Hindi pwede magkapalit. No, kasi sa pagkuha ng value ng small letter n, function siya ng B. Okay. Next, for the third question, ano naman daw yung RU against web yielding? So, specific yung web failure na binigay, web yielding daw. So, again, LRFD design principle, design strength should be greater than or equal to RU. Ano uli yung phi pagka web yielding? So, it's 1.0, diba? So, it's 1.0, ito yun. Tapos, this is support reaction, so nasa dulo siya ng beam. So kung nasa dulo siya ng beam, 2.5 of K lang gagamitin natin, dulo ng beam. Ayan. So FY, thickness of the web, LB plus 2.5 of K. So yung LB, again, dapat tama tayo dyan, 300. Tapos i-equate mo lang siya dun sa, yan na yung pinaka-RU. So direct substitution lang naman lahat ng values, so you will arrive with that RU. Okay? So these are the RU values based from the three possible failures. So kung meron pang tanong na ano dito yung pinaka-critical na RU among the three possible failures, so you just have to choose whichever is the smallest among these three values of the RU. Okay, so that's all for the analysis. So ganyan lagi pagka-analysis or investigation, no? So we could solve for a RU or we could solve for the design strength based on the given possible failures. I hope you have learned out of this discussion. Thank you.